Hello, eager learners. Welcome to SourceFed. I'm Joe Beretta. According to the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration and numbers, oceans cover 71% of the Earth's surface and are made up of 97% of the planet's water.
Whoa, that's a lot of water.
Now, imagine some guy saunters up to you and says, "Hey guy, did you know that there's an underground ocean here on Earth three times as big as all the other oceans combined?" You'd probably say something like, "Get away from me, crazy guy. I'm trying to enjoy my Arby's in peace." Well, guess what? That guy's not crazy. He's a legit geophysicist slinging knowledge. You've got horsey sauce on your face. That's right. A group of scientists believe they've discovered a massive reservoir of water 440 miles deep down below the surface of the Earth that might just provide a little more insight as to where all of Earth's splishy originated. Contrary to what you're probably thinking right now, they didn't drill down and Aaron Eckert their way to this discovery. That's a core reference. And there isn't an actual ocean down there. At least not oceans as we know them. Atlantic, Pacific, Arctic, Indian, Southern. I hate that kid. Utilizing 2,000 seismometers, geophysicists measured waves generated by earthquakes, and the readings pointed to the existence of a bunch of saturated rock in Earth's transition zone right under the United States. This saturated rock is known as ringwoodite, which is this kick-ass sponge-like mineral that attracts hydrogen and ensnares it, holding water hostage in its molecular structure. Geophysicist Steve Jacobson said, "The ringwoodite is like a sponge soaking up water. There is something very special about the crystal structure of ringwoodite that allows it to attract hydrogen and trap water. This mineral can contain a lot of water under conditions of the deep mantle. If just 1% of the weight of mantle rock located in the transition zone is H2O, that would be equivalent to nearly three times the amount of water in our oceans." Totes interesting, right? Even more totes interesting is that if the water truly does exist, it might suggest that Earth's water came from within through some sort of massive Earth-water cycle instead of by icy comet way back when the Earth was an impressionable youth.
Good! We don't want your alien water!
Earl, what are you doing?
Quiet, woman! I'm shooting science!
Now, of course, they're just playing with theories right now, but a piece of ringwoodite, actually the only piece of ringwoodite from deep inside the Earth that we have our grubby human hands on, that traveled up via volcanic eruption in Brazil, throws a little bit of support behind this theory, which is pretty cool.
No, it ain't, because there ain't no such thing as water rocks! Now get your godless minerals and get out of here! Get!